Leica and Magnum, a partnership that has spanned more than three quarters of a century. Some of the most defining photographs of the 20th century have been captured through the eyes of Magnum photographers and the lens of a Leica.
Don't you mind people grinning in your face? Don't mind people grinning in your face.
My first serious piece of work, which I'm still proud of, was done when I discovered that there was a little island off the coast of South Carolina that was inhabited by descendants of plantation slaves. So I found my way to this island with my Leica. I did what was in those days called a photographic essay. And this was the life of a little boy who lived on the island and went gathering oysters and crabs with his grandfather.
A true friend is hard to find. Don't you mind people grinning in your face. Don't mind people grinning in your face.
I was a student at the University of South Carolina. And it was a segregated state university. I wrote the first anti-segregation editorials in the university newspaper. We got threatening phone calls, and I went out a couple of times into the cotton fields at night and photographed the Ku Klux Klan. I went to Greece, where I stayed for about 3 years, and because I was of Greek descent, they were going to put me in the Greek army. I got in my little Volkswagen Beetle and drove from Athens to Paris. I went to the Magnum office and left a box of my first Greek portfolio pictures. Left them there, went back to Greece, forgot about it, and I was in a village on top of a mountain. And there was a letter in the mail from Magnum Photos. Dear Costa, we have just had the annual meeting and you're invited to become an associate. In those, you know, those early years while I was doing assignment work, I was also going mainly back to the South, looking for things to do for myself. I did a piece on a sharecropper family in South Carolina. I would go out to their house and just photograph their lives, and the boys would go out and plow the field. I think it's an important piece of work because it may be the only sort of record of a typical sharecropper family in the South in those days. That was just about the time that, you know, segregation was beginning to end. In 1966, I was in the South, and I came upon the funeral of a African-American boy who was killed in Vietnam. I just stumbled upon it. It all happened within 20 minutes and 10 rolls of film. I grew up in a Greek family, and I always felt somewhat of an outsider. That's why I have this fascination with America. And once I was asked by a newspaper reporter in Greece, he said, "What is your opinion of the United States?" My answer was, Yamiriki ini mia salate pudenehi anakatothi. The United States is a salad that hasn't been tossed. That's why much later I began photographing in color, and I found it to be very exotic. Just a Leica rangefinder camera. It's been that way all through my life.